Hello friends, welcome back once again in the series of the Pharmacology Digester. Today we are going to discuss the mechanism of action of the anti-emetic drug. So before starting to the pharmacology of the anti-emetic drug, I will just discuss about the first, the basic mechanism behind the emesis and the different signaling pathway or the receptor which are responsible or active during the emesis. So here I have summarized the all the emesis mechanism pathway. So just have a basic look on this. Starting with the first of all, the main here is the center, that is the vomiting center, and this vomiting center is located into the medulla. This is located into the medulla oblongata, and this medulla center is first primary center from which the emesis started, and this vomiting center have the different receptor, muscarinic M1 and M3 receptor, histaminic receptor H1, and the serotonergic receptor, that is the 5-HT3 receptor, is present on the basically on the vomiting center. This vomiting center is stimulated by the various different stimuli, and this stimuli originated from where, take one by one. First thing, here is the pharynx and GIT. Sometimes we eat some food, and by this waste food, or we can say degraded food, can induce the vomiting. Then how it can happen? Then that food or that stimulate the 5-HT3 receptor into the pharynx or the GIT, and in the GIT this 5-HT3 will further stimulate the vomiting center. Through this vomiting center the emesis occurs. First mechanism. Second mechanisms, sometimes we smell bad smell, or some thoughts, some very bad thoughts will also induce the vomiting. This type of vomiting is called as the anticipatory emesis. Here is the anticipatory emesis. This anticipatory emesis starting from the cerebral cortex. From the cerebral cortex, this anticipatory emesis induces the vomiting center and finally causes the emesis. Next, here is the some opioids and sometimes chemotherapy. Lot of time this question was asked, that the chemotherapeutic drug or the chemo drug where stimulate the emesis. So here cancer chemotherapy, all the cancer chemotherapy drug used, all the, they stimulate the CTZ receptor, because in the CTZ receptor there are the different muscarinic M1 receptor, histaminic H1, dopaminergic D2 receptor, 5-HT3 receptor, and also opioid receptor. So when the vomiting occurs due to the opioid, then this opioid stimulate the CTZ, and this CTZ will further stimulate the vomiting center from the in the medulla, and the emesis occurs. Here is a very important point. This vomiting center is covered or packed through the triple B, blood brain barrier. The CTZ center, here this CTZ center is not covered through the triple B, blood brain barrier. So this is a very important point. CTZ is not covered through the triple B. Now the next center here is the vestibular nuclei, or we can also call this NTS, nucleus tractus solitaire. Nuclei tractus solitaire. This vestibular nuclei have the muscarinic and histaminic receptor, that when the motion sickness, sometimes we travel lot of, when the we travel in the mountain region, or a lot of traveling occurs, then that also induce the vomiting. This type of vomiting called as the motion sickness. This motion sickness is through the NTS center, and that will stimulate the vomiting center. So there are the different mechanism behind the emesis. All this system have the different drug which act on the different portions. I will discuss here all the drugs with their target point in the vomiting center. I hope so this emesis point have clear to you. Now come to the pharmacology of the anti-emetic drug. Anti-emetic drug, on the basis of the receptors which are active here in the emesis pathway, on the basis of this receptor our drug have been classified. First, 5-HT3 antagonist, as we will know very well, we have started from here. 5-HT3 also here is situated. This is the 5-HT3, here also 5-HT3, means 5-HT3 means in all of the serotonergic receptor only 5-HT3 is majorly acting receptor. So here 5-HT3 antagonist example, ondansetron, granisetron, topisetron, ronacetron, and dolacetron, all the cetron. Just you have to find out that the cetron, all the cetron drugs come under the 5-HT3 antagonist, and these have the property that inhibit the 5-HT stimulation or the conduction of the 5-HT. So here, block the depolarizing action of the 5-HT, and by inhibiting the 5-HT3 receptor, where GIT here located into the GIT, CTZ here located into the CTZ. So by inhibiting these target site, this 5-HT3 receptor antagonist can be active or act through the as the antiemetic drug. Now the next class, here we have the muscarinic antagonist. Here we have the M1 receptor antagonist, here we have the M3 receptor. My mistake, M1, M3, here M1. So these, here also M1. So these muscarinic receptor should be blocked by the anti-muscarinic agent. Here is the muscarinic antagonist, hyoscine and diacycline. The next question arises, then why we don't use the M1 receptor antagonist, selective M1 receptor antagonist? Because here we have to find block also the M3 receptor also. So overall, the we use the centrally acting anti-muscarinic agent, that is the diacyclomine and hyoscine. These block the conduction of the nerve impulse, block the nerve impulse conduction in the cholinergic pathway, because this cholinergic pathway will further stimulate the emesis. Now H1 antihistaminics, H2 antihistaminic we have already studied into the ulcer. Here H1 antihistaminics, example diphenhydramine, cyclazine, cinarizine and promethazine, these all are the H1 antihistaminics, and these have the property that inhibit the H1 receptor. Where is the H1 receptor located? Here into the NTS center and in the vomiting center, also in the CTZ center. So this is also very important. Sometimes we find out the question, which drug is effective into the motion sickness? Here into the motion sickness, the main receptor is the H1. So this promethazine is highly or the selective drug of choice for the motion sickness. Here it blocks the histamine mediated action. Now the next one, NK1 antagonist. This is a newer class, NK1 receptor antagonist, the drug is the aprepitant. Basically what happened, NK1 receptor, neurokinin receptor first stimulate the release of the substance P, and that substance P will further stimulate the emetogenic action. So here this NK1 antagonist block NK1 and inhibit the substance P release and further inhibit the release of action of the emetic action. Now the next and important class of the antiemetic drug, prokinetic. First of all, what is the, here we don't have the doubts, means 5-HT3 directly active on the 5-HT3 receptor, all the receptor bases. Here is the class, prokinetic drug, as its name indicate, prokinetic means these are the drugs which stimulate or increase the peristalsis movement, by which the gastric emptying time will, intestinal transit time will be increases, and the further food will be moved out. What are the prokinetic drug? Prokinetic drug are the substance which increase the gastric emptying, by which the food move out from the gastric region to the intestinal region and the emesis decreases. So how it happens? In the prokinetic, there are the different drugs, metoclopramide, domperidone, sisapride, mosapride and etopride. So basically we can say these are the similar single class drug, and metoclopramide and domperidone are the different. So first of all, we will take the metoclopramide. Metoclopramide are the drugs which is a very effective or potent antiemetic drug, because it have the dopaminergic action as well as serotonergic receptor. So here metoclopramide block D2 receptor, 5-HT3 receptor, both can block, and also have the agonist action as the 5-HT4 receptor. So combinedly these will increase the gastric emptying. Next, domperidone is the selective, basically important D2 blocker, and by the blocking the D2 receptor, they also increases the gastric emptying. Sisapride, mosapride and etopride, these all have the mainly property on the active on the 5-HT4 receptor. All are the antagonists, except here 5-HT4 receptor agonist drug have the anti-emetic property. So here these all have the 5-HT4 agonistic action while antagonistic action on the 5-HT3. So very important, all receptor block during the anti-emetic action while 5-HT4 receptor is stimulated to improve the anti-emetic action. Etapride also have small action on the D2 receptor while low 5-HT4 agonistic action. So these are the summary of the emesis and the anti-emetic drugs classification with their mechanism of action. I hope so you will like it. Thank you.